So yeah, some of you might already know the new multiplayer mod that has been blowing up, and tons of people are trying hard to figure out on how to install it. Because of that, I'm doing a video to clear things up. Hello guys, this is onlyabidoang, and today I'm going to teach you on how to install the multiplayer mod for The Sims 4. Now, this might be really complicated and detailed, so please watch the video thoroughly and pay attention to all of the things I said. Without further ado, let's just jump into the tutorial. First of all, before installing the mod, there are several things you need to do. Keep in mind that both players need to do this. First, you have to move your current save files to somewhere else just to be safe if the mod did something wrong with your save. Your save folder is located on Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims 4, and the Saves folder. You can just select all of the contents of the folder and then move it somewhere. Maybe you can create a new folder on the desktop or something. To make sure that your save files isn't there anymore, boot up your game, and if there is no load game option, it means that you've cleared the save file. Now, the second thing you need to do is to clear your mods folder too. If you've installed mods before, you should know that the mods folder is located on the same The Sims 4 folder like before. Move all of your mods somewhere on your computer like what you do with the save folder. If you've never installed mods before, then you don't have to move anything from the mods folder. You can move your save files and mods back after trying out the mod. The third thing you also need to do is to enter the game and make sure that you've allowed mods and script mods in the settings of the game. The fourth thing is to make sure that you have the same packs or DLCs with your partner. If you don't have a few stuff packs and your partner has the ones you don't have, it usually won't really matter. But if you don't have some expansion packs or game packs and your partner has them, they need to disable them. You can watch this video from the same supply that will teach you on how to disable packs without needing to uninstall it. I've put the video link in the description. The fifth thing you need to do is to create a new save that both of you are going to play the mod on. Be sure to have at least more than one Sims in the household. Once you've made the family and moved them to a residential lot, save the game once, exit the game, then go to the save folder that you've accessed before. There you'll see a save file. But there could also be some other versions of the same save file, like version 0, version 1, version 2, etc. Those are just autosaves, so you can just delete them. You will only need this one without any version name. Then send this save file to your partner, and once they got it, your partner should move it to the same save folder too. The sixth thing you need to do is to make sure that both of you are using the same and the newest version of The Sims 4 update. You can take a look what version your game is by going to the main menu and looking on the bottom of the screen. And the seventh thing you need to know is that you both have to have the same version of the mod, especially since the mod got updated frequently. To check on it, go to the mod site, then take a look on the latest commit. It will say something like a day ago or several hours ago, which means that it was last updated on that time. Now that you've already prepared, let's jump on how to install the mod. For now, you can only play with two players, one host and one client. The host is the one who is starting the server, while the client is the one who's joining the server. But don't worry, because the creator is planning to make it playable with more than two people in the future. The installation for the host is a bit different with the installation for the client. I'll be showing two screens from two different computers, so I'll label them client and host on the corner of the screen so you won't get confused. Okay, now I'm going to show you the installation for the host. First, go to the mod download link that I've put in the description, then click the clone or download button. You'll see this window pop up, just click download zip. After that, move the file you just downloaded to your mods folder earlier. And then if you have WinRAR, right click on the file and choose extract here. You should see a folder called The Sims 4 Multiplayer Alpha. Delete the RAR file and that's it. The host doesn't have to edit the mod files. Now I'll show you on how to start the server as the host. First, go to the site to download ngrok, which is a free software that allows you to host a connection. The download link is in the description. Then click on the Get Started for Free button. Sign up by entering your full name, email, etc. Once you've created the account, you will be sent to this page. Then, download the software depending on your operating system by clicking on the download button. After you finish downloading, move it somewhere else cleaner, such as a new folder or something. Then extract the file like before. A file called ngrok.exe will appear. Open it. Then once it's open, go back to the website. You then have to copy this to authorize the app, without the slash and the dot. Then paste it on the ngrok window that we just started. Then press enter. Keep in mind that you only need to authorize it once, so if you want to start up another server in the computer, you don't need to authorize it again. After that, you have to type in this exact command, ngrok space tcp space 9999. Then click enter. A new window will pop up and get loaded for a while. After it finishes loading, you will see this io.ngrok thing along with some numbers right next to it. Your partner will need these numbers, so copy it and then send it to your partner, which is the client. Keep the server window up for now. Now that you've set up a server as the host, let's get to the installation for the client. Now we're moving on to the client computer. First, the client has to install the mod, which is the same as how the host installed it. Just download the mod and then move it to the mods folder like before. My partner here already did it, and now there's the same TS4 multiplayer alpha1 folder like before. Now, here's where it gets different. First, you have to go to TS4 Multiplayer Alpha 1 folder, scripts, TS4MP, then the core folder. Inside the core folder, right-click in it, choose new, and choose text documents, and name it client, C-L-I-E-N-T. After creating that, go back to the TS4MP folder and go to the configs folder. You will see a file called server_config. Right-click on it, choose Open With, and choose Notepad. If you can't find it, click on More Apps and find Notepad. Once you've opened it, you need to change the numbers on the port with the numbers that the host has sent you. After that, save the change and close it. You now have finished setting up the client. Now let's get back to the host computer. Okay, so before trying to connect with the client, I'm gonna explain what these words mean in the server window. To know if the client has connected, you have to take a look on the OPN here and the number below it. If it's 0, it means that you both are not connected. And if it changed to 1, it means that you both are connected. If it changed from 1 to 0, then the TTL changed to 1 or more than 1, it means that you both got disconnected at some point. You have to make another server if you get disconnected, which means a new port number. Now both of you are ready to start the game, but you have to time it correctly. First, the host need to start up the game first. Let's start it up real quick here. I'm gonna have to fast forward this part so it's faster. Okay, once it's started, stay on the main menu and take a look on the server window. Now tell your partner, which is the client, to enter the game now. Also, tell them to stay on the main menu too. I'm also gonna fast forward this part of the video. Once they finish loading the game, take a look on the host server window. The number below the OPN should change from 0 to 1, which means that you both are connected. Now the host needs to load the save that you have made for the multiplayer first. Now choose their home and wait for it until it finishes loading the lot. After it finishes loading, pause the game. Now tell the client to also load the same save. The client will then enter the save and load the lot. Again, I'm gonna fast forward this whole part since it took a lot of time. Loading the lot might took a while because it's trying to sync with the host. Now once the client enters the lot, they will see a broken interface. As you can see here, you cannot see their needs, their emotions, etc. To turn it back to normal, the host need to press Ctrl plus Shift plus C to activate the cheat console and type in @client_sims. Then press Enter. After that, the client should be able to see the interface normally. Now let's test it out a little bit by controlling my sim here and see if it's also working on the other computer. Yep, it's connected. Now my partner is going to do something. Let's see. Oh, so she's going to go to the top. Oh wait, that's an autonomous interaction, not from my partner. Okay, now she's going to do something. Oh, she's watching the TV. Okay. Yeah, it's working alright. Congratulations, you both can now play The Sims 4 on multiplayer. Also, throughout the multiplayer gameplay, keep taking a look on the server window to see if you both are still connected or not. If you got disconnected, it could mean that the network is a bit slow. The next time you want to play The Sims 4 normally, you can remove the multiplayer mod first. Also, yes, custom contents and mods are working in multiplayer as long as both the host and the client have the same mods and custom contents. Now, if you have done everything correctly on this video but for some reason still can't get it to work, you can go to the Discord server that I've put in the description and ask for support there. If you want to see this mod in action, I've uploaded a gameplay video of it that you can click on right now where I demonstrate how multiplayer works, even with other mods. Thank you so much guys for watching. Also, special thanks to Sims Trooper who took part as the client here. You can check her channel here. I hope that you click the like button below, and if you like what you've just watched and want more, be sure to subscribe to the channel. See you later!